Welcome to Retro Machines. My name is Victor Bart, and for the new server build, today we're gonna try out a motherboard, and this is an Intel S2400 with dual socket 1356. It's brand new, it's an old stock motherboard, so probably it was a spare part for a company, or this was the board that came back from RMA or something like that. And we have 12 memory banks, 2 CPU sockets, socket 1356, so that is a bit strange platform with really cheap CPUs. We have SATA ports here, 2 SATA 600, some extra SAS connectors, and with a special chip you can also use SAS on board, but I don't have the chip. We have 2 PCI 16X slots and 3 8X slots, so you can even use this motherboard as a workstation. A normal PCI slot, Intel S2400 GP4, and the 4 stands for the 4 gigabit Ethernet ports at the back. We also have 4 USB, VGA, COM port here and a COM port here, and a lot of PCIe slots, and that's why I really love this motherboard with a lot of memory banks. I got this 3U server chassis, so let's see if we can fit in the motherboard. But the case and the motherboard are all normal ATX stuff. And here we have the coolers, 2 passive coolers, and my Noctua 4U cooler. It is a too tall cooler, but I think I'm gonna use it for the testing. I borrowed this E5-2407 to test out the motherboard. But in the final build I will use 2 CPUs, because otherwise I can't use all the memory banks and only half of the PCI slots. So let's see if the motherboard will fit in the case. So we need to check out the motherboard stands and make some room here. So let's remove the SAS cables. Okay, we hit our first problem. Here's a 24 pin and it's a quite a short cable. But the connector is here, so we need to have an extension cable. And here we have the 8 pin, and it's like 1 centimeter too short. And we have an 8 pin here. Okay, this one looks long enough, but barely long enough. Because we have a CPU cooler here, yeah. That just works. So we need to buy an extension kit for the power supply. I don't think I can fit the motherboard in here and test it out, so maybe I can pull out the power supply and test it out on the workbench instead of in the case. Okay, let's remove the motherboard and check the motherboard stands, because there was a different motherboard in the case, so we need to double check it all. Only the one in the middle is removable, but let's check out how they will match the motherboard. Or maybe they don't match and then we have an issue. Okay, we have a big issue. Because the one here doesn't line up. This one is directly under the power connector. This one looks fine. Here's nothing. The one on the middle hits the memory bank, so we can remove that one. The one here is correct, this one is correct. Here is nothing. Here there's one under the motherboard. This one is correct. And we have a big issue, because we need to remove a few and put a few in where there's not a hole. I have an idea. I'm gonna use this foam as a template where the screws needs to go. So we can put the motherboard on the foam and use a pen and make dots where the screws go. So I did a drawing of the motherboard so I can really see where the components are. So now we can drop the template into the case and easily see that this one is correct. This one needs to go. Here we need to add one. Here we need to add one. Here we have one that needs to be removed. And here we have one that needs to be added, but there's not a hole that we can use. So this one needs to go, but it's not screwed in. And from the other side, you see that they are pushed in flat. So maybe I can use a hammer to remove them. Otherwise, I need to drill them out. So let's try to use a hammer to remove them. I'm gonna use the big hammer on the other side, so I don't gonna bend the case. And really sorry, Kat. Not working. Maybe a tool and bend it a little bit to make some room. Yeah, it feels that it comes loose, so... Why am I using this shitty tool? This is much better. Okay, it's removed now, but also the collar broke off. So I can't reuse this one on another part. So the next one is the one here. Okay, that was easy. So the motherboard should fit now, but I think I'm gonna just remove the power supply and test it out outside the case. And when the set is working, I will try to mount the motherboard in the case and see what kind of cables I need for the power supply to make it working. The brand of the power supply is Emax and it's a 600 watt unit, so that's more than enough for my file server. So time to install the CPU. This is the first socket and this is the second socket. And I think these are the memory banks for this socket and these are the memory banks for this socket, because the memory controller is in the CPU. Let's inspect the socket before installing a CPU. Don't forget some terminal paste, and I'm gonna use really cheap stuff now because it's only for the testing. And let's install this Noctua cooler, but this is a 4U unit. So in the final build, I will use this kind of cooling block probably. Normally this cooler has two 92mm fans, but I only need one for the testing. So here we have the memory, and I have 6 memory modules. Each module is 16GB and they are quad ranked. So they are a little bit slower, but a high capacity per module. So let's first put in 3 memory modules and see if the system will boot up. Now let's see if we can connect the power supply, otherwise we can't use the system for testing. So we have a shorter 8 pin and a longer 8 pin, and here are the 24 pin. So let's first start with this one. Okay, that fits. Then the short 8 pin. That also fits. And then we have the longer 8 pin. And yeah, I think I can make it work, but it barely fits. Yeah, it works, but we need to be careful. There's here a metal piece that it doesn't short out the motherboard. Yeah, I think we can power up the motherboard like this. I just noticed that this corner is a little bit bent up. So I hope this motherboard doesn't have an issue with it. Okay, the power supply is connected, CPU installed, memory installed. Keyboard, VGA, so let's try it out. It's a bit unclear the pin layout from the front header connector, but let's see if I can make it work. Okay, we have LEDs by the memory banks, by the power plugs. Also here, so... And here, so there's some life in the motherboard. It was like 11, so let's try that. It said something about 11 and 13. 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, 13. That doesn't work. Okay, I have it on the correct power button here, so... But nothing happens. Let's see if we can find a BIOS reset jumper. Sometimes if it's on the wrong position, it won't turn on. Or maybe the BIOS battery is empty. That's also a possibility. Okay, the BIOS battery says 3 volts. So let's put a jumper on the chassis intruder detection. And that doesn't help. And that also doesn't help. So here are all the jumpers for the BIOS clear. So let's try that out. Also nothing. It doesn't turn on and I don't know why. There are some lights on the motherboard, but it is not beeping, not a fan spin, not even a little spin. The power button is on the right connector, but the motherboard is bent here. So let's remove the memory and just see if it just gives an error because it doesn't detect any memory or something. Or maybe it must be in the other memory bank, but I don't think so, but let's see. I think this motherboard is broken. And that really sucks because it's a pretty rare platform, so finding another motherboard is maybe also a bit more difficult. I know that this power supply is working because the board that was in the server was running on it. But let's try another power supply and only connect the 8 pin on here and see just what happens. Okay, it gives LEDs. But still nothing happens. I need to think about this. The board doesn't turn on, so there's a big chance that this board is broken, and that really sucks. I tried even off camera all kinds of stuff with it, and I checked the manuals and the quick start guides, and nothing helps. So I think with this project I need to go back to the drawing board and see what else I can find in parts. Or maybe someone has a tip to get this up and running, but I don't know it at this moment. So a little update on the client side. My workstation is now running with a 10 gig solar flare card, but last night I didn't have the extra fan on it and it overheated and it dropped out of window. So I need to have active cooling on the network card, but it's working fine with cooling. And here we have the switch and a lot of cables and mesh because I was trying out all kinds of configurations. But the switch is working great and this UTP is to my network. So in the test server I put some 80 gigabyte hard drives and they are like brand new with only 60 hours of runtime. Because the 500 gigabyte hard drives too had some problems. But now with these drives I can make arrays and test things out. And also we have a solar flare in the server running on the FreeBSD, on the Sigma NAS, and also on the FreeNAS it's working. And also connected to the switch now with a direct cable, but also with fiber. So let's end this video now. I'm gonna make a new plan for the motherboard. Thanks for watching. And if you like to support me, I have Patreon, I have Amazon affiliated links, I have Twitter, and you can join Retro Machines on Facebook. So let's try to at least make a funny thumbnail for this video and don't turn me into a meme.